So today we're going to talk about the ATPL subjects, and before I do that I wanted to explain a little bit about the different licenses PPL, CPL and ATPL. The PPL is the private pilot license. It's the license that allows you to fly privately but without earning money, so not commercially. The CPL is commercial pilot license. With a commercial pilot license, you are allowed to fly as a profession, so as a professional pilot for an airline or a business jet. The ATPL is the airline transport pilot license. During flight school, you will do the ATPL theory, but you will not do the practical ATPL exam until you've reached 1,500 hours of flight time. So let's talk about the ATPL theory today. We will get in flight school 14 subjects, of which we will do 14 exams. I'm going to explain a little bit about all of them in the following stories. Airlol. You will learn all about the rules of the air traffic control procedures, and everything you legally need to know about aviation. Aircraft General Knowledge, AJK, is all about the airframe, systems such as the hydraulic system and the pneumatic system, electrics and a power plant, the engines. In mass and balance, you will learn the importance and the calculation of the correct loading of the aircraft with regards to passengers, cargo, fuel and luggage. In flight planning, you will learn how to prepare a flight, from filing a flight plan to calculating the distance and how much fuel you will need for a specific route. In human performance and limitations, we learn all about the human body and what high altitude does to our bodies. But we also learn about visual illusions in flight, human error risk in aviation, and crew resource management, CRM. In general navigation, you will learn how to navigate using all different types of charts. You will learn a lot about magnetism and compasses, and about why airplanes don't fly straight lines when crossing part of the globe. In radio navigation, we learn how to navigate with radio beacons such as the VOR, DME, ILS and GPS. In meteorology, we learn all about the atmosphere, about all different types of weather, climatology, pressure systems, fronts, everything. It's very interesting, especially the part of the clouds. I really liked it. With instrumentation, you will learn all about the flight instruments such as the altimeter, airspeed indicator, vertical speed indicator, but also the autopilot, inertial navigation and reference systems, everything. In performance, we learn all about the performance of the aircraft in different phases of flight, such as landing, takeoff and go around. This has to do with the power settings, flap settings, runway conditions and prevailing wind. Operational procedures is all about standard operational procedures and rules in aviation. It's quite a tough subject because all information comes from different ICAO documents and it can be really confusing. Principles of flight is probably by most pilots considered the most difficult subject of all 14. This is about aerodynamics, about subsonic speeds, flight controls, stability and control, a lot. Communications VFR for visual flight rules and communications IFR for instrumental flight rules are quite similar. It's all about how to communicate with the air traffic control in standard, non-standard and emergency situations. As you can imagine, this is a lot to study. Usually flight schools take 10 to 12 months to pass the theoretical part, and when you've passed all those 14 exams, you get to go flying. All about that tomorrow.